A sadu is the traditional weaving practiced across the Arabian Peninsula. A sadu in Arabic means the weaving that is formed in a horizontal style. The loom used in the weaving is also called a sadu. The traditional weaving of a sadu is practiced by the ladies across the Gulf countries and the Middle East. A sadu is practiced across the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia and Kuwait, among Bedouin tribes who settle in several parts of the country. A sadu was created by the Bedouin tribes in the past as part of their livelihood in the desert climate. The materials used to make a sadu came from their surrounding environment. Their weaving techniques created thick and durable panels, which are used to build tents and other products that help them in their daily living.
قالت ترى عشا كان عندي والغداك هم تليم من الحليب اللي تنفش واللي تبرم واللي تغزل واللي تسدى واللي تشلف يعني مثل خرج مثل شيء تشلف تسويه لبنتها تبي تروح به بنتها كان عندها شيء جاهز يعني جايبتها من بيتها تساعد اخوي قصيرتها تساعد المعرسة هذية حدتها لها سدو سوت لها عدول سوت لها مزاود وساحة يعني تحطها درع.
Men help in the first stage of this craftsmanship by shearing the wool of sheep or hair of goats as the raw material that is used in the weaving. The hair of camel is usually not sheared but collected when it falls. The ladies would clean the wool from dirt and twigs, then wash it and dry it in the sun. Next, the wool is combed with a brush with steel teeth called al-kirdash until its fibers are balanced and suitable for spinning. These fibers are then put in a spinner called al-mughzal, which carries the wool during the spinning process. The yarn produced from this instrument is then spun into balls. The next step is dyeing the wool, which is usually done only for the sheep's white wool, not the goat or camel hair. In the past, natural colors were extracted from plants and desert herbs, but now synthetic colors are used. Woven dyed yarns are then used in the manufacture of a sadu by laying the main yarns on the loom vertically, then weaving other lines horizontally. Different patterns are made using different colors of threads in a process called al-hati or al-shamf.
إن حرفة السدو أثرت على انفعالات الناسجة وعواطفها وتأقلمها مع البيئة. برزت من خلال هذه من خلال قطعة النسيج اللي تعمل عليها. تأثرت الناسجة بالبيئة المجاورة لها في نقشات السدو حينما نلاحظ نقشات السدو تجد هلال تجد نجمة تجد بعض الحيوانات مثل العقرب مثل الثعبان.
The weaver uses tools from her natural surroundings like al-misha, which is a wooden stick where the threads are wrapped. The stick is passed horizontally through the vertical lines, alternating it in a delicately calculated manner. Those vertical threads are spread by the horn of a gazelle called al-qarn or al-midra, which pulls the threads in proper order while weaving. The weaved lines are stacked closely by a wooden panel called al-minshiza.
كان اهتمامي نتيجة ما لاحظته من تدني عدد الناسجات عندنا في الكويت انحسار هذا العدد إلى أن من أهم الأسباب هو عدم راحة الجيل الجديد الآن أو اللي هما البنات الصغار في النسج لأنه ما يقدرون يقعدون على الأرض لفترات طويلة بسبب تعودهم على الجلوس على كرسي والطاولة في المدارس.
Nowadays, a sadu is used as a decorative aspect in the homes, which gives a traditional touch to it. The heritage is transmitted by teaching girls the stages of crafting a sadu through observation and practice. Girls usually need a short period of time to learn the various tasks of this craftsmanship, and the more they practice, the more they master it. In 2018, the Ministry of Education in Kuwait implemented sadu weaving as part of art classes for the 8th grade.
بداية أخذنا الدورة من توجيه التربية الفنية مع بيت السدو، وبدينا نشتغل بالسدو المبتدئ، تعليم مبتدئ. بعد ما خلصت الفترة صار في عندنا رغبة إحنا أكثر من معلمة إن نتعلم أكثر.
The craftsmanship of a Sadu is an important element in the local community in both Saudi Arabia and Kuwait. Programs and initiatives in both countries encourage the practice of a Sadu. The Saudi Handicrafts program created a database for practitioners to encourage the practice of a Sadu. Many foundations and societies created workshops led by master practitioners to teach younger ones, which helps ensure the viability of the craftsmanship.
The society is a weaving and handcraft cooperative that preserves and promotes traditional weavings of Kuwait, known as Al Sadu. It is housed in a beautiful traditional house that serves as a cultural center, known as Sadu House. The heart of the co-op lies within the shop, which serves as a platform to share and showcase the weavers' and members' pieces. Profits go directly to the shareholders. A museum gives visitors a glimpse into the traditional weavings of Kuwait and is told in an interactive story of weavings from desert to town. The center shares knowledge through workshops for adults and for children throughout the cultural season. And the library is open to scholars researching crafts and textiles and also includes our published books.
Such role is also played by private institutes which sponsor artisans and provide them with fostering environment for practicing this craftsmanship and incorporate their weaved pieces into modern designs.
في البداية لو احنا نتكلم عن كيفية صون التراث الكويتي المادي واللامادي وكذلك صون التراث بشكل خاص بحرفة السدو من خلال كثرة اعطاء الدورات بشكل رئيسي، نشرة للمجتمع والتعريف فيه بدون الإخلال بهويته. إحنا مع التجديد والمعاصرة من غير تشويه، فنكون بداية ننشر وعي كافي للشباب إنه يحافظون على حرفة السدو ويطورونها بكل ما هم يشوفونه معاصر، لكن ما نهضم حق الأصالة.
Sadu has become an artistic addition to many products and gifts, showing a beautiful harmony between heritage and modernity.
من 28 سنة نشتغل بالدمج. شغلنا بالدمج واللي هو الدمج القديم التراث الأصول أصلنا مع الجديد. الدمج يعطيه لذة، شيء غريب وشيء فريد. مثلا الجلسات اللي نسويها احنا، ايش نسوي الجلسات؟ نستعمل القماش الموجود نوعية جيدة. بعدين ندمج فيها قطعة سدو يعني من الأمام ومن الخلف.
The craftsmanship of a Sadu has a historical value in documenting the tribal desert life. Its inscription as an intangible cultural heritage will encourage the practice within the community and enhance its national identity.